Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading History of Waterdeep 2, which I found in a commoner's house in North Baldur's Gate. History of Waterdeep, Age 0, Trade Moots and Pioneers. Few now know the true history of this great city, which had its beginnings over 1,000 years ago, when the North was truly what Southerners still sneeringly call it the Savage North. In those days, most of the North was covered with vast, tall forests of ancient green, and inhabited by dwarves and goblin kind, in the most northern mountains and foothills, and elves in widely scattered forest enclaves everywhere else. A few primitive human tribes lived along the Sword Coast, fishing, hunting, and gathering in spring and fall, to trade their furs with vessels sailing in from the south, for merchants' jewelry, metal tools, and the occasionally available weapon or two. In the spring, these vessels came primarily to cut and take huge trees for shipbuilding, trees being no longer available in such large sizes farther south. In the fall, the vessels came in to cut timber for their own repairs, or to take on a cargo of wood if the misfortunes of trading had left their holds low or empty. Most of these trade moots were at a certain place where there was a great natural deep-water harbor, protected from the sea by a rocky spur of land, an arm of an isolated coastal crag, or a rocky island beyond it. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate, History of Waterdeep 2.